What's up, everybody? Welcome to YA. We're so excited to be in this new building. But if you guys are able, would you please stand as we go into a time of worship? Put our hands together. Sing "Let Praise."
Let praise be a weapon that silences the enemy. Let praise be a weapon that conquers all anxiety. We let it rise. Let praise arise. We sing your name in the dark and it changes. Everything we sing with all we are, and we claim your victory. We let it rise, let praise arise. Yeah. We'll see you break down every wall, we'll watch the giants fall, for fear cannot survive when we praise you, the God of. On our side, forever lift him high, with all creation cry, God, we praise you. Oh, we praise you. Oh, let faith be the song that overcomes the raging sea, and let faith be the song that calms the storm inside of me. Let it rise, let faith arise, yeah. We'll see you break down every wall, we'll watch the giants fall, for fear cannot survive when we praise you, the God of breakthroughs on our side, forever lifted high, with all creation cry, God. This is what heaven sounds like. We praise you, we praise you. This is what living looks like. This is what freedom feels like. This is what heaven sounds like. We praise you, we praise you. This is what living looks like. This is what freedom feels like. This is what heaven sounds like. We praise you, we praise you. This is what living looks like. This is what freedom feels like. This is what heaven sounds like. We praise you, we praise. We'll see you break down every wall. We'll watch the giants fall. For fear cannot survive when we praise you. The God of breakthroughs on our side. Forever lives in high. With all creation cry, God, we praise you. We'll see you break down every wall. We'll watch the giants fall. For fear cannot survive when we praise you. The God of breakthroughs on our side. Forever lives in high. With all creation.
Praise you, oh, yeah. This is a Jesus. We praise your name tonight. We glorify you, the name above all names, and King of Kings. We honor you, Lord.
I will live on the altar.
Okay, there we go. Hey, we're going to take a moment real quick. You guys can grab a seat. I'm like right in your guys' lap here. I did not feel like standing on the stage. We're going to take a moment. Just have a seat. Have a seat. How's everyone doing? How you guys doing? I do the thumbs up. Everyone knows we do the thumb test here because it's the only way to get honest answers. Okay. I'm looking around. I see it. Hey, my name is Dylan. Welcome to Atmosphere Young Adults. We're excited you're here. There's a bunch of you guys, man. I think this might be your first time, maybe your second time. And you're this is our first time as a young adults group gathering in this building. This is actually the only the second ever gathering ever that has been in this building. This is a brand new spot. So we are working the kinks out of gathering in here. You guys got the memo of don't sit where the ropes are. We were like not wanting people just to hide. Sorry if you're a hider. We tried to keep you close. We just want to be able to hang out as a community. So just kind of an update, what we've been doing, where we're going, who we are as a group, especially if you haven't ever been here before. Like I said, we are Atmosphere Young Adults. We have been in a series as a group through the Sermon on the Mount. So the Sermon on the Mount is in Matthew chapter 5 through chapter 7, and it's the probably the most famous, the most important collection of teachings from Jesus that he ever gives. And it's basically this summary, this description, these thesis statements of what it means to be a follower of Jesus in this kingdom of God. And we've kind of figured out that the kingdom of God is not anything like the kingdom of this world. That might be unfamiliar to you, that it's called an upside-down kingdom, and that the least are the greatest, that the last are the first. And we learn that the people that are welcome into the kingdom of God are the most broken people, and it's not the people that have it all together. And through that, Jesus then shows us, hey, as a follower of me, man, what does life look like moving forward? What is it, who is welcome? What do I expect? How do I interact with my followers? Things like that is what we've been learning through the Sermon on the Mount. It's been a lot of fun. It's been a lot of fun. So tonight, just to now give you the update, we're moving into this new space. Tonight was supposed to be just a continuation in that conversation through Matthew chapter 5 again. And we were going to be continuing that. Pastor Jim was going to be speaking here tonight, right now where I'm standing. And about an hour before, I get a text from him. So this is about an hour ago. He's like, dude, I have a terrible fever. I'm wrecked. There's no way I'm making it tonight. So we're like, okay, we got to figure this out. And that's okay. So he's going to be here next week. And so we decided, as opposed to rushing into the teaching that we were going to cover tonight, which is super, super important, one of the most important teachings in all of the Sermon on the Mount, one of the most important teachings of all the Bible, instead of rushing into it, rushing through it, we're going to wait and allow him to teach us next Tuesday and continue to teach through the series we've been doing. And so we decided instead to take a pause tonight, which is okay. It actually works out because we have our housewarming party tonight. This is the new house that we're in, and we're going to warm it with a party. So there's going to be free dinner in just a little while, less than half an hour. The food will be here. And we're going to hang out and play trivia and just kick it, get to know each other. And it's going to be a lot of fun. So that's already, it works out. Tonight's going to be a little bit different. So if this is your first time here, I say all that to say, man, we're working the kinks out of the new building and also kind of running on, kind of had to change things on the fly. And so that's the plan. And so we were originally just kind of going to roll through worship and go into that. But I felt kind of this pause from the Lord on my heart. Like, man, there's something that he wants us to do with this pause that we have in the series and a conversation he wants us to have. So we're going to do that. So like I said, we're learning kind of who is Jesus through this series. Who is he? What is he asking of us? What is he doing to chase us down? What are these? We're learning about the character of Jesus, and we're learning how he interacts with his followers. And so I'm going to read a verse, and it's going to continue right into that trend, but it's going to be something a little bit different for our time tonight. And so this is in Revelation chapter 3, and this is in verse 20. Now, some of you, anyone reads from Revelation, you start getting scared. I totally understand. But tonight, we're not gonna do that. So this is chapter 20. It says this. Here I am. This is Jesus talking. Here I am. I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come in and eat with that person and they with me. I actually like the translation in a couple of the other Bibles I read out of the NIV, a couple of the other ones that say, I will come in and dine with that person and they will dine with me. And that word was something that the Lord actually put on my heart a couple weeks ago, was this idea that he wants to dine with us. And so, man, I don't know where each and every one of you guys comes in your walk with Jesus. If you have, man, I've been following him with all of my heart for so long, or I just showed up to this group because someone told me they'd take me to dinner after. I don't know where you're at, and I'm like stoked that you're here regardless. But I want to tell you something. Maybe you've walked away from your faith. Maybe you've been struggling and questioning. I really don't know. But I want to show you a characteristic and a truth about Jesus. Is that there? We serve a God as followers of Jesus. We serve a God that is desiring to come and eat with us and come and dine with us. Now, what does that mean? If you are sitting down at a meal with someone, there is a level of intimacy and a level of relationship. And that is the literal words that we see used by Jesus in this passage. And it's the heart of Jesus that we see all through the scriptures. And so what I want to do tonight is it's either challenge you, remind you, maybe just bring you back to a truth that you've known for a long time, is that the God of the universe, the God that created you, the God that created me, the God that whatever, I don't know what your view of him is desiring, according to the scripture, according to what we've been learning, is desiring for you to come and dine with him. It says he stands at the door and he knocks. And we're going to get into this topic, I think, later in our series too, a little further. But he desires to dine with you. Now, that is, like I said, a desire from Jesus to have a level of intimacy with you. And so we have, you know, not really the ability in these scenes. You see, sometimes Jesus would actually, obviously, like the Last Supper, or times he was constantly sitting down and literally eating with his disciples, wanting to meet with them, wanting to share meals with them, this, that, and the other. We can't necessarily physically like put up those tables and like have Chick-fil-A with Jesus sitting across the table. Unfortunately, I would love to do that. I think that'd be really fun, but I don't think we can do. I'm sure he would eat Chick-fil-A, right? I'm sure he would. That's the Lord's chicken. But tonight he's not here for Chick-fil-A, I ask. So the way that we can mimic that table, the way that we can mimic dining with him, and again, this could be foreign to you, so I'm inviting you and challenging you to something new. The way that we can mimic dining with Jesus, the way that it was done then, but to make it a reality for us now, to remind ourselves of the intimacy he desires with you. Again, I don't know where you come from, but there's this truth that he desires that intimacy, is by taking communion. And so that's what we wanted to do tonight, is as we have a kind of a forced pause in our series, was to pause for a moment of intimacy with Jesus, pause for a moment to dine with him. And so what communion is you probably, I don't know what, I grew up Catholic, and that was something I was always like, you know, I crossed my arms when I walked up. I don't know if you've been Catholic. I wasn't allowed to take communion because I don't know what your, kind of like what your experience is with communion. But here, we believe that communion, if Jesus is your Lord, Jesus is your Savior, you have surrendered your heart and your life to him. Communion is the thing that you take as a remembrance of the body and the blood as they were broken and spilled for our sins on the cross. And so we take that as remembrance, and it's a reminder that he desires, he stands at the door and he knocks and desires to dine with us. And so I know for me, as I've grown in my faith, communion has been something that brings me, like it's grounded me in a way that I didn't ever really realize. Like before, it was just like it's going to be over there, the cup, and it was just something I would do, and I was like, yeah, whatever, we take communion. But if you could sit here in this moment, again, if you are a follower of Jesus, man, Jesus is my Lord, Jesus is my Savior, you sit here in this moment, just, I don't know, maybe you've been running from God, you're uncertain of who he is in your life, you haven't quite turned back to following him. Maybe you've been following him for a really long time. Whatever those places may be, sit in a moment and be kind of grounded on the truth that he desires to dine with you. He desires to sit with you. And that truth, for me, it wrecks me. And it reminds me of like what true love is. It reminds me of what that relationship that it is that he desires with me. So we're going to take communion tonight. It's as simple as that. I'm going to bring the basket up here, just kind of at your own speed, whatever you want to do. You can come up here, maybe grab it for the people around you. Just grab communion. Again, this is, if you are a follower of Jesus, man, this is who I am. Take communion. If not, there's no pressure. There's actually a truth that you shouldn't take communion if that's not who you are. That's okay. There's no shame in that. The invitation is still for you the same, to sit here and reflect, man, who is Jesus to me? And see if maybe he might reveal himself to you in a new way. But we're going to take communion. We're going to dine with Jesus, kind of just pause for a moment of closeness with him, kind of ground ourselves. Maybe life has been busy or whatever. Maybe slow down for a moment tonight. Then we're going to go back after that, shortly after that. The band's going to lead us into a couple more songs of worship. And then we're going to go on with our party tonight, which is going to be sweet. But we're going to take this moment right now, this forced pause in our series, to pause ourselves. Does that make sense? Does that sound good? Like I said, just kind of just this thing that we felt the Lord was leading us to tonight as we're forced to slow down. So I'm going to grab this right now real quick. And then at your own pace, at your own will, whatever you want to do, I guess the front group up here is the closest to you guys. Come up and grab communion and just take it back with you and pause. Maybe read that scripture in Revelation chapter 3, verse 20, that he desires. He knocks on the door of your heart. He says, I want to dine with you. Come and dine with me and see what that might do with your picture and your reminder of who Jesus is for you. And then we'll continue into worship. So do that. There's no dismissal. This isn't class. Just come up whenever you want. Grab communion. We'll be back together in just a minute. Thank you.
your powerful name, Lord, the name of Jesus, just right now in your own words, whatever circumstance you're going through, whatever heartbreak, trial, tribulation, something that you really have to just put your faith and hope and trust in the Lord, just speak the name of Jesus right now out loud over that situation, over that family, over that school situation, over that anxiety, over that depression. Just speak the name of Jesus. There's nothing more powerful than the name of Jesus. Just say, Jesus, you're above it all. Jesus, I plead your blood. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. You're so worthy, God. You're so worthy.
Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Oh, we praise God. Oh, how you lifted up. The Lord is my shepherd, and he is everything I need. So I will not worry, and I will not fear the enemy. Know that he loves me. He said that he's with me, even though I walk through the valley of shadow and death, and still I know he has good plans. He has good plans for me. So I will take heart in deserts and gardens. He has good plans for me. If I know my Father, I know my Father. Good plans. Savior, so why would I doubt my victory? And why would I worry? The rod and the staff that comforts me, he quiets the waters, he quiets the storm inside of me. So what could be better than walking with him? Thank you.
so thankful to be here. So thankful to be in your presence. Thankful to worship you and know that you're a good God, that you're here for us. You have plans to prosper us, plans for a good future. Lord, if we came in tonight not believing that, not knowing that, Lord, I pray that you will switch our mindset. Lord, if there's something in our hearts that's saying, I want more of this, Lord, I pray that you'll encourage us to press deeper. Jesus, I pray tonight as we celebrate, as we just have fellowship together and community, Lord, I just pray that we can have fun. In your holy name we pray. Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. You guys can have a seat. Have a seat. Man, nothing more needs to be said. That was incredible. Hey, thanks for worshiping and hanging out with us tonight so far. Like I said, we're going to kind of, tonight is totally different, and so just super grateful that you guys are here and rolling with it. What we will do now is just kind of hang out for a second. Kenzie has gone to retrieve the dinner, and so if you're hungry, it won't be much longer, and we'll get together and we'll eat. But in the meantime, what we'll do, we'll kind of get us ahead for our game tonight, is get to know some people. If you came by yourself, you're going to have to. We're going to get into teams for trivia. Now, I put the trivia questions together, okay, disclaimer, and they're not that easy. If you say they're easy, I'll just be an idiot, and that's just the case. I didn't think they were that easy, so I was like, how can I make this, like, torture? And so that's what I did, and it's going to be great. So you'll get into teams for trivia. You could just kind of sit in the seats. However, you're going to also be probably eating with those people, so, you know, make sure they won't steal your food. And then teams of eight will be the max, because there's, like, a some sort of gold medal that she bought for the winning team, and she said eight was the most she bought. So anyway, just take some time, maybe get to know some people, hang out. If you got it, want to go grab a drink or whatever from the back, but we're gonna carry on into our trivia and into dinner and stuff like that. So get with a group of people. If you don't know anyone, you're like, I'm freaking out, come grab me and we'll help you out, and then we'll get ready to rock and roll. Sound good? Cool. Okay, make some friends, hang out for a minute.